And that pruning and shedding causes both of those things to happen. It causes it to be powerful and a learning machine, but it also causes it to become very inefficient in other areas. And one of those is self-control and emotions. And I mean, we're all smiling and nodding. It's like, yeah, we see it. And it's why my husband and I do this all the time. One minute we're looking at our kids going, oh my gosh, we have the two greatest kids in the world. High five for raising good kids. You know, we're like, they are amazing. They're problem solving and they're doing these things. We're like, then the next minute they know, they're like, you know, stuffing something up their nose and shooting it out to see how far it'll go. And we're like, are you the same kid that just did that? Yes, that's what's going on in their brains at the. And I really had to, I don't know about you guys, but as an educator, I really had to monitor myself because I realized every day when they walked through my door, I didn't know if I was getting a child or a budding adult because their brains are going back and forth between those as they do this neural shedding. And so that's part of this piece. So what do we know about this? What we know is because it is a prime time for learning and there is the brains are just ripe for doing anything, we have to look at how today's students, these 21st century students work. And what we know is they do to learn instead of learning to do. And that's key because we all learn to do. And that's what we're used to. And so, I look and I say, how can you not look at this first and do the, and you need to figure this out first before you do it. I'm going to give you a good example of how I saw this in my own life. Presentations, I like to put in video clips sometimes. And I got really good at using Windows Movie Maker Live. And I could download something from YouTube and I could clip just the part I wanted and embed it in my presentation. I could do it like that. And to be a digital immigrant, I thought, gosh, I'm pretty good at this, right? All right, so one day I go to do it and I'm like, where's Movie Maker Live? What's going on? Where is it? I can't tell it. So I go, I take my little Microsoft Surface, I take it to the Microsoft store, and I'm like, find Movie Maker Live for me. And the guy's like, oh, Windows doesn't have Movie Maker Live anymore. We took it off. I'm like, so as I'm hyperventilating, and he's bringing me a bag to breathe through, he's like, oh, but there are so many other video editing tools online. Just pull, you can pull in, they're free, you can pull them up. And I'm like, okay, what one do you recommend? He told me, I'm like, okay, all right, I'll go do that. So I go home and I pull up the one he recommended. Well, guess what it pulls up? The tool. And I'm like, okay, so now how do you use it? How do you use it? So I start looking, you know, clicking on all the stuff, the help menus and all this. No help. The help menus were no help. And so I'm getting a little verbal. You can ask my husband about this. I'm griping and complaining and gritching about why in the world would they put this out there and not put any instructions with it? What do they think we're supposed to do? Blah, 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 blah. I'm Googling instructions for it, doing all this. Well, finally, one of our sons comes to me and says, what are you trying to do? I said, nothing real big. I have this piece from School of Rock that I want to clip Jack Black from here to here and then put it in my video. That's all I want to do, but there's no instructions for this. And he's like, well, what are you using? And I told him, and he kind of nods and walks away. I'm like, kind of thinking, thanks for the help. And so I'm still like trying to figure out a place to find the instructions. I'm Googling that, looking. I'm even like willing to watch a YouTube video about it. So I'm looking to see if there's something on YouTube. While I'm still looking, he comes to me and he goes, is this what you were wanting? And there's the clip, edited and put it ready to put in my PowerPoint. I said, how'd you do that? Where'd you find? He goes, I just played with the software until I figured out how to do it. That's the way they learn. That's the way those brains learn. So when we need to capitalize on that. We need to capitalize. They are do-to-learners, not learn-to-doers. And had I made him sit down, which then I'm like guilting myself because I'm like, I think I did something similar to my students where I made them sit down and find the stuff in order to figure out how to do it. They don't need to do that. And we need, and what's making their brains grow is them doing that type of problem solving. So since we know this about 21st century students, we know about that high level of plasticity for the brain, what does this mean to us for teaching the teen brain? It means two things. We have got to provide a productive struggle. If we are giving them information that we're asking them to spit back to us, if we are giving them work to complete that doesn't require them to have any level of real challenge, what they're doing, first of all, I'll tell you, here's what they're not doing. They're not complaining. They're not going to complain. You give them low-level work, they're not going to complain. They're going to do it, hand it in, and guess what's happening in their brain? What you saw happening in that kid's brain, okay? And they like it. So don't
think they're going to complain on you. You provide them a productive struggle, something to grapple with. Give them some type of real-world problem where they have to do to learn, and that's where those neurons, that new growth is happening. So let's take a look. There is a teacher that did this very well for his students. So I want you to watch the learning experience he provided for them. And I'd like you to think about, how did this particular experience address what's happening in the teenage brains at this point?